1. Know your ideal client. Your ideal client profile is one of the most vital components you need to have in place when it comes to building a successful business. When you know it, you'll be in the best position to build and grow a highly successful business. The key to a business owner's success is dependent on your ability to generate revenue. Sales and marketing are the only two options you have for doing that. Instead of looking at marketing as a fear-inducing mass of options, the process becomes simple when you focus not just on attracting more clients, but on attracting your ideal clients. That is when your revenue skyrockets, and it can skyrocket by as much as 16 times if you do it well. If you are already working extremely hard in your business, the idea is not to make you work 16 times harder, but actually to have you work smarter and in fact have more time than ever before to enjoy your family, friends, and life. So what is the definition of an ideal client? How will you know one when you see one? You probably already have some ideal clients in your business. 1. They want what you sell. They don't just need it. 2. They are also passionate about what you sell and feel they couldn't live without it. 3. You get fewer returns and complaints. 4. They will spend more money with you over their lifetime than the average client ever would. 5. They often demand additional products and services from you that they want to buy because they trust you. 6. They send you referrals and unsolicited testimonials. 7. They talk about you to friends and family and on social networking sites. Take a moment to imagine your business filled with clients like these. Would it have a different level of income? Would your enjoyment of the business be higher? Would you wake up each day with a spring in your step? What would it do to your creativity and your profits? When you properly and specifically identify your ideal client, you will find that you are working less and earning more. Identifying your ideal clients also has a major impact on your business long term. Since your ideal clients trust you implicitly, it impacts new product or service development, since you will have your ideal client in mind. Customer service, since you focus on what matters to your ideal client. Marketing and sales, since you want to consider their values and issues in your material. So it is not an exaggeration to say that the most productive activity any business owner can undertake early on is to find these ideal clients, give them exactly what they want, build into your business unprecedented and extraordinary value that makes those clients feel compelled to buy from you, and then make sure that your business has the ability to communicate that value to your prospects in a targeted way. Simply put, you can't be all things to all people, and yet, the majority of the websites we see reflect businesses that are trying to do exactly that and be everything to everyone. What happens is that they look exactly like their competitors, and since everyone looks the same, prospects automatically default to the business offering the lowest price. Identifying your ideal client, then innovating your business to serve a niche that speaks to that client, is the way to shift your whole business life from the competitive plane, where there's always someone coming up who is cheaper, faster, or newer, to the creative plane, where you literally create your own market, which might be smaller and more focused, but which will bring you much more revenue. So how do you find these ideal clients? We are all familiar with demographics. If you sell directly to consumers, B2C, then demographics are the statistical elements that apply to your current clients, such as their age, gender, education, marital status, income level, employment status, and so on. If you sell to other businesses, B2B, then the demographics include the size of the company, the turnover, the location, and so on. Demographics define the physical characteristics of every human being or company who needs what you sell. Think about everyone who may need what you sell. Are they mostly men or mostly women? Is there a certain age group or age range that needs your product or service, such as teenagers or retired couples? Are they most likely single, married, divorced, or widowed? What is their approximate income level? What postal area do they live in? This demographic information plays a big role in crafting the right marketing message because marketing to an 18-year-old man takes an entirely different message than marketing to a 55-year-old woman. So it's understandable that when developing a client profile, the demographic information is the category all businesses focus on, and it is enough for most businesses to start printing leaflets and designing websites and other such marketing tactics based on their perceived demographic profile. But it is also the single biggest contributor to why most businesses fail within their first couple of years. The demographics are not the keys to your business success. The psychographics are. Demographics are important because they help you to recognize your ideal client when you see them. Unfortunately, demographics only identify the available universe of prospects who need what you sell. But in fact, we now know from our ideal client definition above that the prospects you are looking for are those who want what you sell. And that is defined not by demographics, but by psychographics. Demographics identify all available people who need what you sell. Identifying your demographics correctly makes up only around 10% of the success equation for your business. The remaining 90% of your success will be determined by how accurately you detail your ideal client's psychographic profile, which simply identifies what it is that they want. Demographics define the physical characteristics of your prospects. Psychographics are the emotional components that get your prospects to buy what you sell. Prospects buy based on emotion and they justify their purchase with logic. Prospects may or may not buy what they need, but they will always buy what they want. This needs versus want scenario is a very powerful concept for a business owner to understand. Virtually every decision we ever make as human beings can be traced back to our desire to avoid pain or to gain pleasure. And we are generally much more motivated by the avoidance of pain than the prospect of pleasure. So when you supply your product or service to your prospects, it is important to think about how their current situation, before they get the benefit of your product, is affecting them personally. What are they finding problematic? What are they frustrated by or worried about? We refer to these issues, whatever they are, as hot buttons. Think about buying a car. You want to buy a Mercedes. What you need to buy is a metal casing with an engine that will get you from A to B. Any car with a decent engine and a reasonable comfort will do the job. But you end up buying a Mercedes, not because you needed it, but because you wanted it. Your decision is driven emotionally, and that holds true for any product or service you buy, even if you don't always recognize the emotional driver up front. What we tend to do is make an emotionally driven purchase of something we want and then justify that purchase with logic. I need a Mercedes because I'm on the road so much. I need something safe and comfortable. Or the quality of Mercedes means it lasts much longer than a cheaper car. Another example. What if your old computer is running fine, but you see a brand new Mac that's slim, fast, and looks stunning, and that you really want? You can afford to buy it, but you don't need it, since your current laptop is working just fine. What are the odds that you will buy it? If you do buy it, it will be based on your emotions, and when your partner or friends ask you why you bought it, you will justify it with logic. You will say things like, It has a faster processor. It never gets a virus. It's easier for me to carry when I travel, and so on. Prospects buy what they want and not what they need, and they buy based on emotions and justify their purchase with logic. Wants are emotion-based. Needs are logic-based. When creating compelling marketing, you need to tap into your prospect's emotional hot buttons with your marketing messages. If you focus only on your demographics, then you will be forced to compete on price and not value. Prospects buy value. When they cannot determine the business that offers them the most value, then they default to price. Focusing on your ideal client will help separate your business from everyone else in a similar field. How do I identify my ideal client? Step 1. Identify your client's demographics. Start with a tentative list of traits of every human on the planet who may possibly need what you sell. Keep it broad and general for now. If you have clients, look at a typical range of 5 to 10 of your clients and note down demographic traits that are meaningful for your business. You can look at these main areas to start with. Age range. Does your product or service cater to a specific age group like young kids, teenagers, baby boomers, or retirees? Gender. Is your product or service used primarily by men, women, or both genders? Income range. What income level do you currently serve? The idea is to find the widest group you could possibly serve right now in income and all other demographic areas. Location. Is your target customer primarily urban or suburban or rural? Prospects in a very big city have very different transport and locational needs than those in the suburbs. Also, which specific region can your business serve? Is it a 2-mile radius or the whole world? Employment status, education. Does your product appeal to executives or to those with higher education? Does it need some degree of technical capability? If you sell to other businesses, the demographics involve turnover of the business, business location or locations, number of employees, and so on. An example of a B2C business might be a construction company who do renovations and extensions on residential property. Their demographics could be men and women, age 25 to 60, married or single or cohabiting, homeowners, household income of $70,000 to $1 million, employed in executive positions or stay at home. It is a wide range because the demographics cover anyone who could potentially have any building work done on their house. For a B2B business example, I could give you EBS Digital, our online marketing company, as an example. In providing everything for your online requirements, from web design and development, as well as search engine optimization and pay-per-click management, apps creation, and so on, our demographics could be almost any business small enough not to have an in-house online team, even startups. Since every business needs a website, and then every business needs to optimize their website and to have an online marketing strategy to grow their business. Turnover of 0 to 10 million, 1 to 300 employees, 1 to 20 locations, any geographic location. Now, since our own SEO company and the construction company from our example have good quality features and provide good service, they could start marketing to this very wide universe of prospects immediately. Most businesses focus on telling their prospects about the features that their business offers, about their great prices, their wonderful service, their incredible range of products, the vast choice and selection that they offer prospects, and other such features. That is one of the biggest mistakes a business can focus on. Your prospects want to know how the products or service that you offer will benefit them. They only want to know about the features of your products or service in so much as how your business relates to them and to their needs and wants. By focusing on the features of the business rather than the benefits to its clients, most businesses finish up looking the same and offering the same or similar services to their competition in an already crowded and competitive marketplace. This does not mean that you can never draw attention to the features and achievements that your business has worked hard to create. But later in this section, when we look at building messaging that really reaches your prospects, we will also look at how to change the focus from features to benefits. Businesses that focus on features almost always compete with each other on price, while businesses that focus on the benefits their product or service is offering to their ideal clients provide value that allows them to set their own prices because they stand out and differentiate themselves from the rest of the marketplace. But how do you make your benefits meaningful? By looking at psychographics. Psychographics. Psychographics begin to define your ideal client's problems, issues, frustrations, and fears, commonly called hot buttons, so that you know specifically what it is they really want from your product or service. The psychographics help you determine what your ideal clients want and not what they need. For example, at EBS Digital, we found that all businesses need some online marketing help at some point. But some businesses just want help designing a website, while others want to know how they can get more leads and close those leads to sales. These are the hot buttons, or deeper emotional triggers, that the psychographics help you define. And in each and every specific situation, your prospects have completely different hot buttons. Your mandate is not to try and deal with all of them, but simply to choose just one of these areas to specialize in and to create your niche market. This way, you begin to separate your business from your competition, and if you select a niche you are interested in or passionate about, you end up enjoying your work a lot more as well. Psychographics are important because they help you understand the emotions that your prospects experience, and it is these emotions that compel them to buy what you sell. If you have a knee injury that needs surgery, do you go to your general practitioner or a doctor who does heart surgery? Or do you want a doctor who has done nothing but knee surgery for the past 10 years? Since you are emotionally invested in the pain and injury, you want the expert and the specialist. Today, that is what most prospects want in every field. The key to your success as a business owner is knowing the emotional hot buttons of your ideal clients. Hot buttons are the compelling problems, fears, frustrations, or concerns that your prospects typically feel when they buy what you sell. They are typically descriptive of a painful feeling, like the dread of a root canal, or the fear that an estimate for building work will be higher than you anticipated. Those are hot buttons, and your business needs to identify the ones that it can deal with for clients. Prospects want to feel special and that a business is catering to them specifically by focusing on their wants and needs. So, if you were running the construction company from our example, what might your prospects' biggest fears and concerns be? Well, if you have ever had work done on your home, you know that people typically have one or more of the following hot buttons. 1. They are worried about going over budget. 2. They are fearful that the builder will start another job halfway through yours and drag your work for weeks or months longer than agreed. 3. They are fearful that the construction will hide poor workmanship. So if you could set up your construction company with good systems so that you could guarantee that the price you quote is the price they will pay, or if you can guarantee your work for 5 years after completion, or if you promise to stick to your schedule or pay them $100 back for every day you go over. Do you think prospects would be lining up to use your services? Do you think they would be willing to pay a little more for good workmanship backed by a guarantee rather than risking a rough ride with someone cheaper? The answer is yes, because you will be marketing to exactly those prospects who want these issues taken away. As a small business owner, your job is to identify and define the most important hot buttons that top the list for your business. In other words, the top needs and wants that lead clients to your business. While this list varies from business to business, it tends to be quite consistent within the particular industry to which your business belongs. So, as a business owner, your next task is to list out these psychographic components, the ones that your ideal prospects are looking for. This will start to impact your demographics and narrow them down somewhat. Now, as a builder, you may want to target people who have previously had poor experiences because they understand emotionally the pain of having had a bad builder who went over time and budget, or who left them with a house full of headaches. If you can offer your guarantee to these people, they will be predisposed to want to work with you. You can begin to see why 90% of the success of that profile involves accurately identifying the psychographics of your ideal client. In some businesses, there's only one major hot button. In others, there may be 10. Some customers may want a low price. Others may want great customer service or a cast iron guarantee. Some may be incompatible with each other when it comes to solving them. For instance, the lowest price might not be possible along with outstanding service, but they are all potentially issues for different sets of prospects. If there are multiple hot buttons, then your task is to select the one that you have a true passion for serving and make that hot button your niche market. That hot button relates to a particular group of prospects that is your ideal client. If you want a truly solid business that has the foundations to grow, you need to know and understand who your ideal client is. When you know and understand their psychographics, you also start to understand how to appeal to their emotions. By targeting their hot buttons, your prospects will pay attention to your message and want to buy what you sell because it solves a major problem, concern, or frustration that they have in their lives. Whatever size your business currently is, you probably do not have cash to waste. Every marketing dollar must generate a positive return on investment. An accurate psychographic profile is the key step in creating a marketing program that generates real financial results by providing the information you need to reach your prospects emotionally. Once you master this process, you'll be able to effectively market your business and to attract as many ideal clients as you want. As with any process, there is a step-by-step approach you need to follow in order to get the results you want, starting with developing your ideal client profile. Without it, you will be selling to anyone who happens to need your product or service. You need to put aside any fear that you might be missing out on selling to everybody, because there are plenty of clients who want what you sell without you attempting to be everything to everyone. Create a list of hot button issues that you feel apply to your business. And remember that this list should focus on the problems or frustrations your prospects have and that you can solve for them. Using EBS Digital as an example, we can theoretically serve millions of small businesses based only on demographics. But if we specialize in helping businesses who have not had good results from their marketing spend before, we can target businesses who already know the value of doing search engine optimization and who want to be sure they will make money doing it. We can leave out marketing to people who are skeptical about online marketing entirely, or those who prefer to do everything themselves. Many times in businesses, 80% of your total revenue comes from 20% of your ideal clients. It's a rule that we'll look at further into this section. For now, just be aware that those 20% are your ideal clients. They spend more, they love your product or service, and they stay with you long-term. What this process aims to do is turn the 20% into the 80%.